Today we're at a Renaissance festival.
Now the bobcat's not going to be a great climber, although all cats are adequate climbers. He's a pretty adequate climber. He's in the bottom cancer cat. The girl is climbing the cat. Why is that? Well, he's got too long a legs and too short of a tail to be.
Now, fortunately for this cat, the fact that he does not have a cat does keep him out of the fur trade. And that is because of his beautiful coat, spots, stripes, and beautiful colors. To put it delicately, no one looks aware of that color. So, it's not just that.
This is Sancho. He is approximately 2.5 years old. He's a whopping 6 pounds. He is full grown. He won't get any bigger. He's actually a little bit plump right now. He's one of the smallest cats in the world. And a lot of people think the smallest cats in the world are domestic cats. But you're far wrong. We've got the black-footed cat found in Africa, weighing at about 4 pounds. The Jaffa cat, the Ancilla, South America.
The genus for the roaring cats. The second is that this cat is not actually completely black. If you were to take a look at Dexter in the right lighting, you would see he has a gorgeous pattern of black rosettes against his dark brown fur. This is the result of a recessive gene called dark melanism.
Now Dexter is full grown, he's 160 pounds, 7 years old, pound for pound, second strongest cat on the planet, capable taking down 300-pound prey items. Now, I don't know where he takes those prey items out, but he'll put it in his jar, hike them straight up into a tree. The reason they do that is to protect the kill from hyenas, lions, other predators that will steal their hard-earned pets.
What you doing,
Kenzie?
Oh, let's go get Daddy Liam, come on.
Stinky?
Yeah.
Stinky.